I mean, I think to sum it up, what we're really looking at is you know, how can we gather data and how can we contribute to moving that data towards a conservation, a planning, or a government process? And we do have one last thing on here, which is a movie that was put together by somebody we were lucky enough to have on our trip, Pierre Cousteau, who now works for the International Union for the Conservation of Nature, or IUCN. Come on up, and maybe what we'll do is we'll show the movie.
I joined IUCN just a couple of weeks ago, so I'm just starting on the project Regenerate, and I got very fortunate to be able to join this expedition and to see what they're doing in the water. You can see a SV2 in action, so a CV2 team in action. They're actually not taking pictures of the poison. Very fortunate to have them. Do that. And yeah, so I put together this little movie here for communication outreach purposes. I mean, you've seen these people are doing amazing work, and it's going to be very useful for benchmarking the state of marine life in the Maldives and following up on that in the future with IUCN and with the Marine Research Center here. Yeah, it's very important that these guys also manage to effectively communicate what they're doing, the research, why they're doing it, and what the results are, and what it means for management. So I think outreach is a very important part of research. And very much I have to say that this is not so important. A lot of you have been diving. Very nice compared to other sites. So very fortunate, and I hope that this kind of study will help to better manage the marine resources that are here for future generations. Here you have the team in action. Maybe you have to be scandalized, but it's going it's all been the same scientific process. And
questions?
Yep, a lot of questions as well. If you have any questions specifically about the Regenerate project, about the North Area expedition that's leaving there in a couple of days, we're here with the rest of us.
Thank you all for your presentations. My name is Charles Axon, and I have a couple of comments rather than questions. First of all, at the very beginning, you mentioned that the coral reefs were in a particularly good state compared to other areas, and one of the factors you mentioned was parrot fishing. And I think that is one of the kind of several contributing factors. But I'd like to just mention that these things never happening in isolation, but in this case, the protection of parrot fishes, which you mentioned, it's really down to one man, a very exceptional Maldivian, the late Maizan Kapalai, who was the founder director of the Marine Research Center. And in the early 1990s, we had a meeting, I still myself for that, and Hassan actually proposed the protection of parrot fishes, and it stems from that one man. So I think that's worth remembering. The second point is, you mentioned the lack of stylophora on the reefs. And they were here before the big bleaching in 1998. And they're gone. So yes, a lot of bleaching. That's it.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, no, good comment. So, and I guess on the note of what you're saying at first about the one person making a difference, that seems great. You know, that really is a great story that somebody can make a difference like that. And I think that's one thing that's really striking to me about coming to the Maldives is that it seems like, to me, I'm on sort of thin ice here, and we visit a lot of other countries, but it seems like the size of a country that can be effectively managed by, you know, a number of people who really care. And I don't get that feeling in other places like Indonesia. There are people there who care, but the country is so big, and in some ways, some of the social forces are so out of control that you're really not able to have an impact to stop, you know, to effectively have conservation as one of your main goals. And, you know, it's hard not to be depressed by that. And that's the difference here, is that I felt like I've met some great people through MRC and through IUCN that really care and seem to be making a great difference here. And we certainly saw that underwater as well. And I'm glad to hear you validate the observation of global extinction. That's great. I mean, not great, but that's interesting. Any other comments or questions? Great. Well, if you have any other questions, I just want to say feel free to contact me at the University of Queensland in Brisbane. I'll be going back there, and we'll be, you know, processing all of this data. And we'd be more than happy to share all of the information that we're gathering, to have discussions about how our data sets might be augmented by other observations or other data sets that researchers here have. You know, certainly contact us, because obviously we're not experts in the Maldives. We spent now a month here. But it would be really great to hear from everybody else, from experts like yourselves in the audience, about what you think some of those observations might mean, or, you know, a better interpretation of them. So please don't hesitate to contact us. Great, and thanks for coming out.